Today in Lucid Training Labs, we're diving into customer journey mapping. As you might already know, a customer journey map is a visual representation of a customer's experience with your brand. These visuals tell a story about a customer's motivations, needs, and feelings as they move through each phase of an interaction. What most people don't know, though, is that not only is a customer journey mapping template a visual and intuitive way to gather information, it can also play a crucial role in alignment, synthesis, and presentation. And it just so happens, the Lucid Visual Collaboration Suite can help us do all of these things. We've established that the first thing our customer journey map template helps us to do is gather information. However, often we don't think about leveraging our customer journey maps as a tool for creating consistency throughout the data gathering process. But if you think about it, when each member of the team uses the same template during their customer interviews, this creates alignment and a shared language around the story that each customer journey map is telling. Let's start by taking a closer look at a Lucidspark template. Here you'll see the common key factors needed for the journey map. Number one is the actor, the customer or person you're interviewing. Number two is scenario and expectation, what the actor is trying to accomplish and what they expect as they do it. Number three is journey phases, the high level, meaningful chunks of time. Number four is actions, mindsets, and emotions, what the person describes about their experiences. And number five is opportunities, insights, and ownership, your reflections about what you learned from the interview. Ideally, we'll want to be making notes as we interview a customer. Then, by the end of the interviews, each member of the team has gathered data in the same way, and it becomes much easier to be aligned when discussing the opportunities, insights, and ownership section of each customer journey map. After aligning on your data gathering, you can move on to synthesis. This is where you have to organize your findings and ideate on possible solutions. This is your space to weigh the pros and cons of different ideas and identify which solution provides the best chance for de-risking your design. If you're having trouble deciding, you can even vote on which ideas to present to stakeholders. You can leverage your customer journey map by using it to guide the conversation as you present your ideas or designs to stakeholders and decision makers. By pointing to specific examples of where your solution addresses specific pain points, you can provide rationale for how your proposal will create a positive customer experience that drives revenue and loyalty to your brand. After all is said and done, you've created a valuable artifact of evidence that supports your proposed solution. Now that we're familiar with the template and the process, let's run through how we'd apply a customer journey mapping template to a real scenario. We've just conducted an interview with George, who is a 32-year-old graphic designer, and we've mapped out his experience purchasing noise-canceling headphones. You'll see here that we've mapped out each section of the customer journey map to show the main components. In the final stages of our interview, George mentions that his difficult checkout experience led him to leave an unfavorable review online. Similar to how we filled out these other sections, we'll take notes on his specific actions and we'll adjust the line here based on the emotions he may have been feeling. We'll include any quotes that stand out to us by using the sticky note tool. And finally, we'll write any possible solutions that come to mind as a result of this pain point here. Now it's time to synthesize our findings. As mentioned earlier, using a customer journey mapping template can help your team to document their findings in a way that creates a shared language around discussion about the customer experience. And now that we're ready to discuss our findings and brainstorm potential solutions, it's easier to synthesize our insights because they were all gathered in the same way. Okay, based on these other interviews, it looks like the checkout process was a pain point for most people based on which credit card they used. I'm also seeing several proposed solutions mentioning that we need to add information to the website to specify which payment methods are accepted. We can even go back to Lucidchart and create a wireframe of what the website will look like with our solution implemented. Now for the presentation. I'll use presentation mode or paths for a more interactive experience, both in Lucidspark, to intentionally create the story of how we came to the conclusion of our proposed solution. I'll include a slide for our customer journey map because it's easily understood and allows us to quickly point to specific evidence that supports our reasoning during our presentation. And there you have it. Using a customer journey mapping template to align, synthesize, and present your findings allows you to confidently move forward with the decision, knowing you've done the due diligence to de-risk your idea and provide your customers with a positive experience. Now it's your turn. Use the links provided in the accompanying support guide to create your own customer journey mapping process. And for even more resources, visit training.lucid.co. Thanks for joining us.